ABC. So Kevin here, or War God 60. I got another update. I usually do a 70s revisited, but where I usually kind of will play songs from a band that'll feature or show on an album, but this is gonna be kind of a little bit different. This is some stuff that I've been kind of picking up over the last couple weeks, and with the exception of these two CDs that I was gonna show in another video and I didn't, but anyway, I picked up some books. Anyway, back to that again. Anyway, what I'm playing is Lynyrd Skynyrd's solo flights, kind of music from members that were in different bands, formed different bands, like Rossington Collins, Alan Collins Band, Artemis Pyle Band, Steve Gaines solo, stuff like that. Solo flights, good stuff. So anyway, the CDs that I had gotten, this came yesterday. I'll take it out of the, so it isn't so blurry. Band called Metal with two L's. And their album is called Metal Fire. Let's see here. It's on Soul Food Records. Iron Shield actually put out, distributed by Soul Food. I'm gonna say this came out, I believe it was this year. So just some great heavy metal. You got a little growly voices in there at times, but just a great album. And then this here, I pre-ordered. Band goes back into the 80s, and they were known as Dungeon back in them days. Trying to find those albums from that band is virtually impossible. I am looking. I've yet to come across anything, and if I do see it, it's like way up in price. This band, 10 years back, maybe a little farther, dropped Dungeon and became Lord. Of course, if you know Dungeon, you know Lord Tim is the guitarist, formed this band Lord. This is their latest release called Fallen Aim or Fallen Idols. Great album. Very great album. First track lead in is a very power thrashy album. And that's basically the only track that is kind of like that, but it's power metal, power thrash song on there. It has a very melodic song on there like he normally does, but definitely a great album. I just wish this was out on vinyl. It was put out by Dominus Records out of Australia. Of course, it was signed. And I tell you guys, you order this stuff from Australia, it's there within 5 days. They let me know when it was shipped, and it was there in 5 days. Got 13 tracks on here, a couple of three bonus tracks, but just released. Great album from Lord. Okay, let me refresh my drink here. Only Coke. I don't drink alcohol. So anyway, mostly 70s bands that have been re-released, or some are originals. And I'm going to start off with this band out of, this one was released in 1977, band called Eagles, and this album is called, and it's hard to read it, I can't even read it, it's hard to read it, Open Up, it's called Open Up by Eagles. I showed one in another update that I had just gotten on Capitol Records, 70s prog rock, very good album. I showed this on my Facebook site, the guy had mentioned that, Very good album. Loved it. So anyway, Ethos from 77. This is a, I don't know if I showed this or not. I might have, but I'm going to show it again. Band called Apollo. This is put out by Savart Records. And I think I did show this. But I think this was originally released in 1970. Band is out of Finland. And let's see what it says. It's the first authorized reissue taken from the original tapes. Apollo is often considered the first Finnish heavy rock group. Notorious for their wild live act, the band's album 1970 is a more varied affair, moods ranging from somber ballads to all-out psychedelic warfare. And anyway, Apollo, I think I picked this up over at Shadow Kingdom. And then these all came from Bomp Records. Not this one, but this one, this one, this one, not that one. Anyway, okay. These all came from Bomp Records. They kind of cater to garage rock, psychedelic rock, blues rock, a lot of rare stuff from the 70s. And this is a band that is quite rare. The band is called Lightning, or they refer to it as White Lightning. And I've been seeing this on a couple of YouTube videos about top 50 psych bands in a certain person's opinion. Of course, this is the cover. It's the white cover. Here's the outer for that cover. And this is the back. Kind of a unique setup. I've never seen one like this before. But the band is White Lightning out of the 70s. I believe this was released originally back about 72. Actually, no. The Lost Duty album from 69. Band is out of Minneapolis, actually. This says Lightning on here, but they were called White Lightning. And, yeah, I picked this up over at Bomb Records. I do buy stuff from there from time to time. And here is the label, or the inner. It is on American Sound Records. So anyway, so you have so you have the band Lightning. White Lightning, actually. And then this band on someone happy day. Somewhere there's people. It's a band called The Witches. Re-released in 2011. This is called A Haunted Person's Guide to the Witches. They were out of Detroit, Michigan. And again, more garage rock. They are on Alive Records. And I'm not sure how many of these, or how many albums The Witches put out. But I believe this is out originally in the 70s, re-released in 2011. I could be wrong, but I think this is from the 70s originally. And I also picked up a band called The Leopards. And Magic Still Exists. It's on a Bob Records. This was released originally in 87. This could be, I think this is originally what it was. So this isn't a 70s one, but limited Bob Green vinyl. And then I picked up band called The Mushrooms and The Taste of them. This is actually an 80s release as well from originally 86. And it was released in 2019 on Garage Rock. And then this one came from Rock and Roll, and I love this band, Kraut Rock band. This is their first album from Eloy. This is on, I believe, Missing Vinyl. This is actually on Music on Vinyl Records as well. It was specially pressed for Missing Vinyl Records, Eloy's first album, recorded originally in 1971. Great prog rock, early German prog rock, just some great stuff from this band. They are actually still around today and still putting out albums. I'll pick this up again over at Rock and Roll. So I'm glad it was repressed. Well, I figured something out. And then I also picked up over there, also a band. I've been contemplating this for about a year to buy this or not. And I did finally pull the prog. It is a decent price. The band is called The Heads. And the album is called Heads Up. I believe this is originally released in 1969, if I'm not mistaken. And just been re-released on Liberty Records. The Heads. Again, you pick these up over at Rock and Roll. The Heads, here you go. And this I picked up over at, I believe it was, might have been Bomb Records as well, but I picked up Sir Lord Baltimore. This is a re-released edition here on 180 gram vinyl. Limited edition classic. This originally came out in early 70s, been re-released in 2010. Some Sir Lord Baltimore. A band that basically should have been bigger, but they weren't. This also came from Bomb Records. This band originally came out of 1970, originally on Liberty Records. Repressed on Bear Family Productions, and the band is, I believe, let's see here, Batards, yeah, the Batards, and the album is called Hit Shock, and has a poster in it, has a price on here, but I didn't pay what that was. It says $29.99, I just don't know why they just don't round it up to $30. We had an ongoing thing one day at work, and it was between myself and another guy that I worked with, who was no longer with us. And we had a kind of a little, well, it was just kind of a little fun thing going on. He said he paid $5 for this, and I looked at it and I said, you didn't pay $5 for that, it was $4.99. No, I paid $5 for it. No, you didn't. You paid $4.99. We're just going on and on and on. It was kind of hilarious. But anyway, rounded up to 30. I think I paid $25 for this originally. But the band is called The Petards, and their album Hip Shock. Got this from Bomp Records. And some more. You can also play this in stereo, and you can play it on mono. More psych hard rock orientated here with the guitars. And then this I bought on Discogs. Again, it was one of my YouTube searches that I go through, and these bands pop up. If I like them, I will go over and search for them on Discogs and usually buy them. Of course, a lot of these bands I haven't heard even back in the 70s. Because again, like I say, if you're localized to a certain area of the country, you only got what you got. Or else big label bands that were distributed throughout the world and the U.S. A lot of these bands were not distributed throughout the whole U.S. Just localized to certain areas of the country. And this is a band here. It was formed in 1970, toured the Midwest, East Coast, they backed Rush, Hawkwind, and Journey. The band is called Pentwater. They're on the Golden Pavilion label. And so it kind of tells you who they were kind of... Where they toured with is kind of like what their style was. They have electric violin in there, haunting flute, deep bass, guitar solo styles of Steve Howe, polyphonic vocals, extreme counterpoints. The album takes us on a journey of unsettling and rhythmic interplays to mellow acoustic textures of dreamy space rock with heavy mellotron and organ themes, dual guitars, and counterpointed vocals. This is on an old school tip-on jacket, 500 copies, and called Pentwater. Also on these labels are bands like Arawak, Raven, Old Raven from 76, and from Switzerland, and Stefano Torossi from Italy in 1974. So our band is called Pentwater. And this is an original of this is very hard to come by. You can't come by it, but you're going to pay astronomically high bucks for this. This is a gem album that I believe came out in 1970 originally. It's been re-released on Recoil. And I'm talking about the band May Blitz and their self-titled album. I mean, look at this cover. It's just absolutely killer. I mean, it's just something you don't see. I mean, for back in the 70s, great album cover. This is a three-piece. And, yeah, this was re-released in 2018, but May Blitz from 70, just some great psych rock back in the early days. This is a gem, pick it up. And then I've been trying to get all this band's original material, whether it's or this band's discography, and I do have quite a bit of it now. There's still a lot out there. The band is still touring. They've been around for 50 years. And there are still two original members left of the band. This was probably their first album, if I'm not mistaken. Originally released in 1969. Re-released in 2015. And talking about Status Quo and their album Spare Parts. I do believe this is their, it's either their first or their second album. I believe this is their first. So I was happy to get this up. I picked this up over at Amazon. So I'm slowly but surely getting all of the Status Quo albums. This band, Wishbone Ash, I'm trying to get. I don't believe Wishbone Ash is still touring, but these guys are. They play at Bakken quite a bit. But great band, Status Quo. And I also picked this up over at Amazon. I got it the other day, and when I got home, I seen the package had a little bend in it. And I went, oh great, another one of these albums. Wasn't broke, but I could tell by just looking at the package that it wasn't not going to be good, and it wasn't. I emailed the guy who had it. This came from the UK. I emailed him. I said, the album looked like a punch bowl, warped as hell. And he was sorry. He said, well, I can refund your money back, or I can send you another copy. And he's sending me another copy. He just told me to throw this away, but I'm going to see what condition that other cover is. And of course, I talk about Status Quo here. You Can't Stand the Heat, which came out in 79 on Phonogram. I don't know if you can see that, but it does have a little bow in it. It's kind of a unique cover. It kind of opens up like this. But what I do not like about these albums is they come out of the bottom, and I don't care about this, but the record is, tried to get it out, it's warped very bad. I don't know if you can see that. Looks like a punch bowl. I have not played it, I won't play it, I'll just wait until the other copy arrives, and then I'll see what the covers look like and exchange it. But the cover is immaculate condition. So we'll see what the other one looks like. Status Quo, if you can't stand the heat. And with that May Blitz, that guy also sent this, but I think it was a filler. And I like some of this band stuff back in the 70s. Wasn't a real huge fan, but I looked at the album and I looked at the cover. It's a promo. Band is Wet Willie. Kind of a hard rock, maybe a little funk orientated band. This is called Dixie Rock. I mean, the cover's in pretty good shape. And I was surprised. I took the album out. It's on Capricorn Records. I looked at the album, and to my amazement, it's actually in very good shape. Not VG Plus, but it's in very good shape. I don't know if he sent that just to send me it or if it was a filler. So I said, heck with it, I'll keep it and clean it up, listen to it, and see how it sounds. Again, I did like some of White Willie's or Wet Willie stuff back in the 70s. This one was originally released in 1975. The last one is iconic band. I mean, iconic, legendary band. I remember first time ever listening to this band was over at a friend of mine's place back in the early 70s. And I was hooked immediately. And the band only put out three albums, but the first album is a legendary, iconic, classic, and I'm talking about Captain Beyond. But this one is just released through Purple Pyramid Records. If you're not familiar, they do a lot of this, releasing live material. I think this is the second one that they've released through Captain Beyond. This is a Captain Beyond Live in Miami, August 19th, 1972. Limited to 500 on blue vinyl. Again, released here a couple weeks ago on Purple Pyramid Records. Of course, it has the legendary lineup: Rod Evans, Rhino Reinhart, Lee Dorman, and Bobby Caldwell. And of course, it has. Let's see. It has A Thousand Days of Yesterday. As the Moon Speaks, To the Waves of the Sea, Astral Lady, Dancing Madly Backwards on the Sea of Air, a classic song. I try to pick up anything I can. Captain Beyond, in fact, Captain Beyond is back together. They've done a few dates, maybe a dozen dates this summer, and as far as I know, they are recording a new album. And as far as I know, it's only Bobby Caldwell, the original, is there on drums. So kind of anxious to see what he comes up with for new Captain Beyond. Hope it's similar to the early style. But anyway, Captain Beyond, live in Miami in 72. So anyway, guys, that is all I have. Hope you enjoy this. Leave any comments below. I did pick up a new camera. This isn't the new camera I'm doing recording on, but I'm going to be doing some recording on a new camera that I bought yesterday. I bought a new Nikon, and I picked up a 128 gig card for it, so I'll be able to hold quite a bit of video on there. Depends on how I record it at and so forth. So probably the next videos I do will be through that camera. Well, I'm going to see how it shows up. But anyway, thanks for watching. Guy comments, leave it below. Thank you.